this is the Provoked Prawn, and this is a video on the new 12th generation Intel motherboards that include the LGA 1700 socket design. Now, these motherboards have a different layout to previous generations, which means that most coolers won't fit as standard with these, with the exception of something like this ROG motherboard. This Strix motherboard has two different sort of holes drilled into it that I'll show you in a second, with a close-up look where you can essentially use older generation CPU coolers, all-in-one coolers or air towers with the original brackets, and you can fit them in those holes on there. But actually, a lot of the other motherboards you'll find with 1700 socket probably won't have this. There are solutions though, and in this video I'm going to be talking to you about the different ones from Corsair, NZXT and Noctua. Now, the manufacturers usually are supplying a bracket accessory pack which you can purchase or get for free, and I'll leave links to those in the description so you can find out more. But in this case, for example, here's Corsair's setup. We have a different backplate which attaches to the rear of the motherboard, and obviously, as I said, you have to watch out for the different hole shapes here. Well, with the standard socket on most motherboards, you won't have the extra holes. But you do have some slight adjustment with this black plate. You just need to remove the sticky tape from the rear and then push it in so that the pins fit through the holes and are in the right position. These are ever so slightly adjustable. It's worth bearing in mind this is a different setup from previous generations though, so it won't work with LGA 1200 socket, for example. But this is an extra pack, so you can essentially get this kit if you're already running a Corsair cooler, whether it's one of the new ELITE CAPELLIX or the older ones. In this video, I'm going to be using the Corsair H100 CPU cooler that I had set up in my machine, and I'm reusing it here as demonstration purposes. So once the backplate screwed in, you use the accompanying standoff screws, which are the same length on either side, and you will have noted that the LGA 1700 on the packet to give you an idea, but you can see they're the same length on either side. Just screwing them down to the four corners. So this is the same process as you would have done for a standard installation. But if you're purchasing the cooler and you're not sure whether it's going to come with this kit and you need to get the accessory kit, this is the process for using this instead of what's included with the cooler as standard. So you can see here I'm fitting on this rather old cooler now, but it's still running nicely. Setting it down. Obviously make sure you apply thermal paste if you're taking your cooler off and putting it on a new motherboard, or if it doesn't already have thermal paste applied, you do need to apply a thermal paste. I haven't in that case because it's just for demonstration purposes, but make sure you apply thermal paste. Now, Noctua also has a kit. This was for the NHD15S that I recently unboxed and installed. However, you might find that if you purchase one of these kits, or you buy it secondhand, or if you already have one, you can't use it with a new motherboard. However, there is a kit that you can get from Noctua, and I'll leave a link in the description so you can access this, which includes everything you need. This is a convenient little kit as well, because you can see, for example, that the secure Firm 2 backplate already has the pins pre-installed. So the installation process is to feed those pins through the back of the motherboard and then use the blue standoffs, then to mount the mounting arms on top of that and secure them with the thumb screws. Obviously, you can set up your cooler in different directions on this setup, and it will depend on the motherboard you're using. I went into more depth on this on the video, but for this installation, I actually had to set it up the wrong way, non-standard position, because of the VRM on this motherboard blocking some of the heatsink fins. So it's worth noting that you can install this in two different directions, and this is the 90 degree angle. Now here's NZXT solution. This is for the Kraken Z73, where it'll be the same sort of kit for all the Kraken coolers. Essentially, not only do we have a new backplate, but we also have a new bracket that mounts to the pump head as well. Luckily, the installation process is fairly straightforward again, and also you also have the screws included in the box. Those standoff screws are obviously important to install. The first part of it is to flip the motherboard over or access it via the back of your case, depending on whether it's installed or not, and then put this backplate into place. You will notice again that you can adjust where the pins are when doing this, so it is worth making sure they're fitting through the holes properly and in the same spots, because obviously with these extra length holes on this motherboard, they could end up in different positions, which wouldn't be ideal. So we need to make sure they're all in the same place and that they can reach the new bracket and new pins. The backplate here doesn't have any sticky tape, so you just need to make sure it's secured and held in place while you install the standoff screws. Again, fitting each into the same corners, and you can just obviously just seat those down and make sure they're nicely secured into place. And then once again, thermal paste if you haven't got it on already, or if it's pre-applied as it usually is. It isn't here. I would apply thermal paste before I'm reusing this from another build, so this is just for demonstration purposes. Remove the standard bracket that's installed. You can see the difference between them in a second. This is basically held in place with clips. You just need to turn it ever so slightly and it will pop off. It's really easy to do, no hassles at all there. You can see the difference between them there. Just some slight differences in the notch system and where that fits and how the standoffs will sit through that bracket. So again, we just repeat the process for reinstalling it. You just need to slide it over and turn it ever so slightly and it'll clip back into place. Then reapply the thermal paste, or if you have this straight out of the box with thermal paste, seat the pump down onto the CPU and screw it in place with the four thumb screws that come with the thing, and then obviously connect up all the wires. I have links to the videos on these coolers if you're interested in the description, if you've not seen them already and are curious. NZXT Kraken Z73 is a fantastic one, for example. I love it because of the display and all the wonder that it can offer. But obviously Corsair's new ELITE CAPELLIX coolers offer something similar. And now with these extra kits, you can easily install them on the 12th gen motherboards. I want to give a quick shout out to my extra special YouTube members. And those lovely people include Meaty Keyboard, Raw, JShank007, Bird412, Sir Swanslot, Strastins, and Aaron Yarden and Beaster Bunny. Those are awesome people that have clicked that join button to help support the channel and are benefiting from the various things that I have on offer at the moment. And why don't you have a click and see what you think? And also let me know in the comments if you've got any questions. Thanks for watching. This has been the Provoked Prawn. Hope you found this video useful, interesting, hilarious, or otherwise. Take a look at these other videos that I think you might find interesting as well. And have a look at the description for links and other information you might find useful. Click that join button to see the benefits of being a member of my YouTube channel. And most importantly, have a great life.